Good morning, students. In previous class, we have seen about the definition of transducer and types of resistive transducer, etc. And this class, we are going to start about inductive transducer. And before that, I like to explain what is transducer with the help of a video. And here is the video of what is a transducer. And we have come across this transducer in daily life without knowing that it is a transducer. So we have seen the automatic opening and closing doors in restaurants and some other places. And have you ever thought how that doors open and close? And we have seen this infrared emitter on the top of the door, which is going to radiate infrared rays, and it is reflected by the person when he comes near the door, and this reflected rays is received by the device, which converts it into electrical energy, and this electrical energy will energize the motor connected to the door, and the motor start opens. So this device which converts electrical light energy into electrical energy is known as a transducer. So your transducer is an electronic device which converts from one form of energy into another form. So some of the examples of your transducer are: first one is photo transistor. It converts light energy into electrical energy. And LVDT, it converts translational motion into electrical motion. And the final one is thermistor, which senses heat energy into electrical energy. And these are some of the examples of your transducer. And coming back to the lecture, inductive transducer. So it is a self-generating or passive type of transducer. It is either going to operate without any external source, or it needs some external source to operate. So your self-generating type will utilize the basic generator principle. That means your motion in conductor and magnetic field will induce a voltage in the conductor. That voltage is utilized for the operation of your transducer. And this relative motion between the field and the conductor is supplied by changes in measurement. And the variable inductive operation principles are your number of turns, geometry configuration, permeability of your magnetic material. That is, permeability is nothing but the measure of resistance which opposes the formation of your magnetic field over the conductor. And these are the principles in which the inductance of your device is going to vary. And the types of your inductive transducers are shown here. So first one is linear inductive transducer. That is, inductance is going to vary with the help of linear movement of your wiper. And angular inductive transducer, it is similar working as of your linear, but it is going to operate in the angular way. And variable permeability inductive transducer is similar to your LVDT, and here the outer core is made of ferrite and inner core is made of iron, and this outer core is wound with the coil, and this iron core is moved inside this ferrite core, which in turn the movement of the core towards the right end to the left end will causes the formation of magnetic field, and it is going to vary the your inductance value. And here is a variable reluctance inductive transducer. It is going to work in the principle of reluctance. And coming to linear variable differential transformer or transducer, the construction is very simple, and this is one of the most widely used inductive transducer, and it is going to translate the linear motion into an electrical signal. And it has one primary winding and two secondary winding. Primary winding is termed as P, and secondary winding is termed as S1 and S2, which is wound over a hollow bobbin on a non-metallic and insulating material. And the secondary winding S1 and S2 will be having equal number of turns, and it is identically placed on either side of your primary winding. And the movable soft iron core is placed in the former in order to overcome the eddy current loss in the core. And this core is made of nickel ion alloy, and it is slotted very longitudinally. And this is the construction of your LVDT. And as I said earlier, the primary winding is wounded over there, and the secondary winding is wounded on either side of the primary winding. And this is the basic circuit model of your LVDT. That means that the core is moved in between these windings. And coming to the working of your LVDT, the AC source is given to the primary winding, which excites the primary winding, and this AC source voltage will be from 5 volt to 25 volt, and frequency will be from 50 hertz to 20 kilohertz. When the primary winding P is excited by the alternating current source and induces alternating voltages in the secondary winding, those voltages are ES1 and ES2. So it, as it is a differential transformer or transducer, it is going to produce a differential output voltage, which is equals to E0, and it is termed as ES1 minus ES2. So at null position, that is when the core is at the center position, your ES1, that is EMF induced in secondary coil 1, will be equal to EMF induced in secondary coil 2. So output voltage is nothing but ES1 minus ES2. So E0 will be equal to 0 at null position. And when core is moved towards the left side to null position, then E0 is equals to ES1 minus ES2, and E0 is in phase with the primary voltage. That is, it will be positive. And whereas the core moved towards the right to the null position, your E0 is equals to ES2 minus ES1. That is, the value of ES2 will be greater than ES1. So E0 is 180 degree out of phase with your primary voltage. And this is the working of your LVDT. And here is the graph which shows the relationship between your output voltage and displacement. And this graph, from this graph we can understand that there is a delay in the formation of output voltage for some value. Your output voltage stays zero, and this voltage is termed as residual voltage. This residual voltage is due to magnetic or electrical unbalance in the circuit. Also, because of harmonics in the input supply and output voltages, residual voltages are created. And this shows the your voltage value at in phase and out phase positions. And coming to the advantages of LVDT, it has very high range of measurement of displacement and infinite resolution, and it has high sensitivity. That is, the sensitivity value will be 10 millivolt per millimeter to 40 volt per millimeter, and it has high output, and there is no need for amplification, and the absence of sliding contact make it more reliable, and very low hysteresis, and hence repeatability will be excellent in this linear variable differential transducer. And it has rugged construction, and it can tolerate shocks and vibrations. And it is used on high frequencies, that is, the frequency can be up to 20 kilohertz. And it has very simple in construction, small and lightweight, stable and easy to align and maintain, as well as it consumes less than 1 watt of power. These are some advantages of your linear variable differential transducer. And disadvantages, it has large displacement or required for differential output. Whereas the sensitivity, it is very sensitive to stray magnetic fields, and sometimes the performance will be affected due to the vibrations created in your transducer. And the receiving instrument must be selected to operate on AC signal or a demodulated network used if DC output is required. That is, this output will be AC signal. So the device which use this output of your transducer must be a AC device. If it is going to be DC device, we need a demodulator. That is, it has to convert the AC signal into DC signal. And dynamic response is limited mechanically, and the temperature will affect the performance of your linear variable differential transducer. And applications are your measurement of displacement, measurement of force, measurement of weight, measurement of pressure, and measurement of your position can be done with the help of your linear variable differential transducer. I like to explain the construction of your LVDT with the help of this video. So it shows the construction working of your linear variable differential transducer or transformer. So it is a passive transducer which measures displacement, and this is the primary winding which is connected to the AC source, and we have secondary coils. There is two secondary coils having equal number of turns, and it is wounded on either side of your primary winding, and it is interconnected, where the output EMF produced in the secondary winding will be equal to ES1 minus ES2, where it is the net induced EMF. ES1 is induced EMF in S1, ES2 is EMF induced in S2. So while EMF induced by the AC source, it is going to produce magnetic field in the circuit. So now we here it explains the working of your LVDT. So when AC source is activated, alternating current starts flowing in the primary winding, due to which a variable magnetic field is produced. This variable magnetic field will excite the secondary coil, and EMF is induced in the two secondary coils, that is ES1 and ES2. And here is the core which is placed at the center position, that is, I mean it as null position while explaining it. So your ES1 will be equal to ES2, so the differential output will be equals to zero at null position, and that is why it is termed as null position. And if we move the core towards the right side, your ES2 EMF will become greater than ES1, so ES1 will be less than ES2, and the output EMF induced will be equal to ES1 minus ES2. So as ES2 is greater, the value of E0 will be negative. So if the core is moved towards the right side of your primary coil, then ES1 will be greater than ES2, and the output voltage is equals to ES1 minus ES2 will be equal to positive, as ES1 is greater than ES2. Thus LVDT uses the magnitude and polarity of the net EMF induced to measure the displacement of its core from its null position. And this video, I think it explains the construction and working of the LVDT. Now coming back to the PPT, disadvantage, we have seen the advantages and disadvantages of LVDT. Next one is rotary variable differential transformer, that is its construction is going to be different, but the operating principle is going to be same as that of your linear variable differential transducer or transformer. So it is convenient for measuring angular displacement, whereas in LVDT we measure linear displacement. And construction is going to be similar as that of your LVDT, except the core as it is rotated between these winding. This is the core which is going to get rotated between the primary and secondary winding. If it is going to rotate in clockwise direction, there will be the increase in the value of output EMF of one phase. And if it is going to rotate in the counterclockwise direction, then there is the increase in E0 in the opposite phase, that is the output voltage value will be in opposite phase. And this explains about your inductive transducer. These are the types of inductive transducer. And next one is capacitive transducer. And capacitive transducer, the principle of operation is based upon familiar equation for capacitance, what we have studied earlier, and of the parallel plate capacitor. That is, we know the formula for capacitor, which is C is equals to epsilon A divided by D, which is equals to epsilon naught into epsilon R into A divided by D, where your A is overlapping area of plates and D is distance between the two plates. Epsilon naught is the permittivity of the free space, where permittivity epsilon naught equals to 8.854 into 10 to the power minus 12 farad per meter, and epsilon r is relative permittivity of the dielectric. So I stop my lecture here, and we'll continue about the types of capacitive transducer in the next lecture.